centering your machine. Step on with one foot, listen for the chirp, and from there, follow it with your other foot. From there, it takes me almost nothing to move my Segway. Even one arm in front of me will cause me to travel forwards. One arm behind me will cause me to travel in reverse. One finger on the handlebars will cause me to rotate. What I'm getting at here, Segwaying is a very un-extreme activity. You want to look something like this when you're riding around today, and not like that. If you do that, you're just going to look silly. So don't do it. Now that brings me to stopping. We practiced two stops today. The first one's ridiculously simple. You all have already done it. You keep your back straight and simply lean back into your heels, like so. When you do that stop, by the way, it's very important that you move the Segway with your feet and not with your upper torso. You don't want to do like this kind of thing. What you want to do is just keep your back straight, lean back, return it to normal. Now, that's fine for the parking lot, but our tour takes place in San Francisco traffic, and all kinds of exciting stuff's gonna happen today. Buses are gonna try to run us over, hipsters on fixies are gonna cut us off, people might throw lattes at us. We may have to stop suddenly, for which we have another stop. I like to call it the junk in the trunk, the drop it like it's hot, the booty stop, buns of steel. Got all of that?
Yeah.
For a number of reasons, partially because I'm very immature, and partially because you literally use your butt to stop yourself. That one looks kind of like this. Oh no, a squirrel. And a drop like it's hot. Now, I know that looks kind of silly, but it'll do you wonders when you're in the streets of San Francisco. And now's the exciting part. Let's see how you guys do.
Boom, boom, boom.